Namaste. Today we're going to talk about the most basic exercise or most famous exercise or asana, I would say, about core. So whenever you hear about core, whenever I ask anyone that, okay, what exercise do you know about core? Everyone, every single person talk about one exercise, plank. We all know about planks, right? And we all must be knowing somebody who is able to do plank for a long time. But do we actually know how do we do it? How to do it right? I have seen many people are able to do it for 10 minutes, but the form is incorrect. What's the point? When it starts hurting your lower back, when the pressure is coming on your shoulders and not on your core. So let's try and figure out how can you do plank the right way. Alright? So I'm going to show you full plank as well as the plank with the elbows down as well. Alright? Let's see how do we do it. Let's talk about the full plank first. The most important thing what you need to take care of is your shoulder to your palm must be in a line. It's very important that they must be aligned. Second thing, when you keep your legs straight, your back must not be arched like this. These are the common things people usually know about. But the thing what we usually don't know about is that you need to make sure that while doing plank, your heels should be stretched backwards and your upper body should be stretched forward. How do we do that? Just have a look. Most of the people do plank like this. Or you may be the one as well who do it like this. Need to make sure that while doing plank, your heels should be stretched backwards while your upper body is stretched forward. So your upper body is stretched forward and your heels are stretched backwards. When you start doing it like this, it puts lots of pressure on your core. So I'm going to show you all again. How do we do it right? We keep the palms down. We keep the toes down, heels stretched backwards, upper body stretched forward. Like somebody is pulling you from both the sides. And stretch it. Make sure lower back should not be falling. Engage your core muscle. Use your middle back as well. You will be feeling some pressure on your palms, on your wrist, on your shoulders. But maximum on your core. You'll be feeling on your quads as well. But we hold it here only. This is how we do full plank. And trust me, if you're able to do plank for 2 minutes, try it out like this, you will realize it's difficult to do it for a minute as well. Alright, now let's talk about plank with the elbows down, which is the most famous one anyways. Now here again, the most common mistake what I've seen people do is, they keep their palms together. They interlock their fingers, which you should not be doing, because this way you tend to put pressure on your shoulders. What you need to do is you need to keep your palms down like this. Again, elbow to the shoulder must be in a line. Keeping the legs down the same way. Heel stretch backwards, upper body stretch forward, and lower back should not be arched. Straight. Stretch it like this. Good. And do not lift your hips up as well. Hips should not be up. Lower back should not be arched. Lower back straight, tucked in, and hold it like this. This way you feel so much on your core. Instead of keeping your palms like this, you can keep your hands like this as well. But as soon as you do it like this, the pressure starts coming in your palms instead of your core. And we need to feel it on the core. So hold it like this only. You'll be feeling on your core as well as your middle back. And it's too much. You feel it really well. So this is how we do plank. The most famous core exercise. So for plank, there is a name in yoga as well. That's Dandasana. We call it Dandasana. Okay. Now, I'm going to show you one more exercise. One more asana, which is the best asana for core. Like I can say, if you do plank for a minute, and if you do this asana for half a minute, it's equal. So you can imagine how effective this asana could be. So to do this asana, you sit straight, keeping your legs straight, or you can lie down as well. I'm going to show you both ways. So let's start with lying down. We lie down straight. Firstly, we keep both palms down. Now keeping both palms up. Alright? Now what you need to do is you need to lift your upper body up, lower body up, and your palms up. So upper body up, lower body up, and your palms up. And the name of this asana is boot pose, knock asana. Hold it as long as possible and trust me, you will feel it so much. Can't tell you. The best thing with boat pose is you can do variation as well. Like right now we are holding in 45 degrees angle. You can try it in 30 degrees as well, or 15 degrees. Or anyways, holding it like this for as long as possible will put lots of pressure on your core. And people who've already been doing yoga with me, they all know how much we love boat pose, right? We don't do any class without boat pose. Now, I'm gonna show you how do we do it from sitting. From sitting, it may be easier for some, difficult for some. So this is why I've shown two options. Now, we're keeping the toes out and inhale, exhale, hold it like this. Keep holding it like this as long as possible. You can keep your palms here, anywhere. You can keep it like this, like that, anyways, just hold it like this. You will be feeling on your middle back as well as on the core. Try to look up to feel it optimum. Hold it as long as possible. And yes, oh, I'm feeling on my core as well. All right, so I'll be coming up with more videos talking about different asanas, different exercises for different body parts. Right, stay tuned. Thank you so much. Thank you.